Spring crests with a wave of green that rises up from the valley floor and rushes across the plateau. Yellowstone's great herds are returning to one of the last open ranges in North America. In spring's fervor, a resurgent force works to keep the system in balance. The wolf pack. This is the Wapiti pack, the largest in Yellowstone. A family in its prime, 20 members strong, and still growing. They roam the vast interior of Yellowstone, a territory of 200 square miles, perfect wolf habitat. But until recently, gray wolves were gone from this landscape. A century ago, predators were seen as the enemy of progress. Eliminated from nearly all of their former range. Scientists had not yet discovered that an ecosystem cannot thrive without both prey and predator. In 1926, park rangers shot Yellowstone's last wolf. No one understood the consequences. 70 years later, in the winter of 1995, two horse-drawn sleighs carried 15 gray wolves captured in Canada and released them in the Yellowstone backcountry. It was the beginning of one of the most ambitious restoration projects in history. No one knew if the wolves would stay, if they could thrive in an unfamiliar place, or what the long-term effects of their presence would bring to the Yellowstone ecosystem. But it didn't take long for the wolves to make Yellowstone their home. The revival of the hunt returned the most primary dynamic to Yellowstone, a predator pursuing its prey. Thanks to the return of the wolf, the world's first national park is now recognized as one of the only intact ecosystems of its kind. Today, more than 100 descendants of this endeavor roam Yellowstone. The thriving wolf packs keep the grazing herds in check.